Yo, what's up everybody, welcome back to the channel. If it's your first time watching this video, please do me a favor by subscribing and like the video, guys. We are heading to 3k subscribers journey. So today we're gonna be talking about Q&A about the Korean government scholarship, or they call it Global Korea Scholarship, GKS or KGS or KGSP, depending to how. But previously it was known as Korean Government Scholarship, KGSP. So on the Q&A, most questions which have been asked, we're gonna go through a lot of them, but by starting which are the most important, someone was asking like, should I apply through the embassy track, or should I apply through the university track? For my advice, if you are from those countries which the embassy track is applicable, because applying through the embassy track, you got the chance to choose up to three different universities, or to apply up to three majors, three different universities you can apply for. So if you are from those countries which are eligible to apply through the embassy track, make sure go for that embassy track application. But if you are from those countries which you are not eligible to go for the embassy track, you need just to submit the application to the university, you go by university track. So there's no other option, go for university track, because when you apply through the embassy track, you have much more chances to win. You up to three different universities you can select, so meaning you have the high chance to secure admission. Can I apply different majors of studies? The answer is yes. You can apply to different majors of studies, but you should prove them with the statement of purpose or the letter of intent. Those parts you should be able to prove. And when you select in the department, make sure you select the at least related department, so that the statement of purpose can be as a backup to what you are suggesting to go and study. Because if you choose different department, the statement of purpose won't match with the selected departments. If you choose engineering and you choose education, there's no match over that. Is dormitory included in under this scholarship? The answer is no, it is not included. They give you the monthly allowance. So from that monthly allowance is where you can be paying for yourself about the food, the living expenses, the transport, etc., etc. So they don't give you accommodation to stay, but they give you money which you can rent an apartment, you can stay in a hostel, you can stay elsewhere on your own. Is the education in English or Korean language? The answer is it depends. And it depends on the school, it depends on the major which you're choosing to apply, and depends on the professor you select. So for different people, you find maybe you are in the university doing the master's program, but you find maybe on the thesis, maybe your studies can be in Korean language, reading, maybe writing, and you can find maybe thesis you do it in English. Or you can find a university, some university, maybe all this reading, writing, and etc., maybe exams, maybe all upper should maybe in Korean language. So varies depending on the school which you're applying to, the university, that's what I mean, the major which you are choosing, and the professor you select. Now back to other questions over here, which also you see from the screen. What if you don't complete your studies during the scholarship period? Maybe you're going there maybe to do a course, maybe a master's for 3 years, and or 2 years plus one maybe for language. Yeah, what if you don't complete with that? Will the scholarship continue sponsoring you? The answer is no, is no. So the extension is not allowed. The other, may I change my final choice of university when I already moved to Korea, when I'm doing my language course before starting the major? The answer is changing the course is real complicated. So make sure you research about the course which you want to apply at a particular university before writing it down and submitting your application. Can you be exempted from attending the Korean language preparatory course? The answer is yes, depending on the exam. If you ever took the topic, which is a Korean language exam test, if you already did this and you got the marks from level 5 or 6, you will be exempted direct. But if you don't have this, maybe you, if you don't have this and you applied, you won, you got the scholarship, going over there during your language preparatory course, one academic year, at the first semester, if you'll be able to secure 75 or you get topic level 5 or 6 during the first semester of your language practical course, you'll be exempted. So the second semester, you won't go on with doing the language. You just jump direct and start your course, which you are doing from the March. Is it mandatory for all scholarship holders like to get level 3 in topic after the language preparatory course done? Yes, it is mandatory to get that. You should make sure you end this at least level 3 in topic, because there are level 1 up to 7. So at least you end level 3 for you to proceed with your studies, with your major of studies. I'm an EMBA struck applicant. I'm aware that I have to choose at least one university from type B. Does this mean that I can only choose one university from type B? No, you can choose but what they mean here, you must choose university from type B, not choosing only university from type A. With that being said, you can choose all university from type B, or choosing from type A, and or maybe two from type A and one from type B, at least one from type B during application for those EMBA Struck applicants. And I'm going to apply for the program via the EMBA Struck. And for here, you got three preferred universities and department or major. Any tips over here? You should make sure those three majors you choose, or university you choose, you make sure you check the admission criteria so that you meet with the department you are selecting to get enrolled to, because you can get notified or recommended by passing through the first round, maybe selection committee. You pass through maybe the embassy evaluation process. When you pass through that, but when your application is submitted to the university to secure admission, you can find some applicant failed to secure admission in all the three selected universities. So make sure you research. You check for the universities which are highly competitive, and you check for the one which you are able to secure admission. How many majors and universities can you apply for admission? If you apply through the university track, you can just apply to one major, to one university. But if you apply through the EMBAS, you can apply up to three universities or three majors. Can you choose any field of studies for master's or doctoral program? No, you can choose only those programs which are listed under this scholarship program. If you are living in a country where you got many embassies for Korea, maybe like in USA, maybe you got in Los Angeles, in Washington DC, you can submit to the nearest embassy of Korea. I am Japanese citizen currently living in Vietnam. May I apply for this program through the Korean embassy in Vietnam? The answer is no. The application you should submit to the embassy, to the Korean embassy in your home country, your nationality, where your residence is, not where you are living, but where your nationality is. The Korean embassy over there should submit your application directly there. How do I submit my document written in language other than Korean or English? You should submit your original with a translated but notarized by notary public. I will apply through the EMBAS track. According to the guideline, I should submit 4 sets of application document, 1 original document and 3 photocopies. How do I submit my certificate, such as transcript, graduation certificate or recommendation letter? So all certificate must be presented in their original forms. For example, ask your university to ensure you have 4 sets of transcript and 4 sets of degree certificate. 4 sets of transcript and 4 sets of degree certificate. However, if that can't be done, like some you can't get like that, you must submit photocopied document, because the original document cannot be reissued again. You should submit now authenticated, notarized, apostilled or consular confirmed documents in lieu of original document. Then make 3 copies, 3 more sets of copies of authenticated documents. So they should be notarized, verify that they are true. And after that, you can make copies of those notarized and you submit as 4 sets of application for those who are applying through the embassy track. Should I include a detailed research proposal in a statement of purpose? The answer is yes. You must describe and please elaborate on your study objectives in Korea, the plans of studying over here, and plans during and after you complete the degree program. If your wish is to work over here for some time before moving back to your home country, or to stay over here to work in Korea when you come over here, or you when you graduate you go back. So list on that on their statement of purpose. I'm planning to apply for 2021 the scholarship, but I got the recommendation last year, maybe 2020. No, can I use the same recommendation to apply for this scholarship? The answer is hell no. You should use the one which is most recent according to the application deadline. How many recommendation letters should I submit? For Embassy Track applicants, we must submit one original and three copies. How do we make copies of sealed recommendation letters? So you should not make copies of sealed, because if you unseal it, then you are lost. So an IED requires applicant to get recommendation letters from two different recommenders. For Embassy Track applicant, as a recommendation letter cannot be opened by an applicant, you should ask each of your recommender to write one original recommendation letter. Each recommender should make three copies of the original document letter, sign each letter and seal them all together in one envelope and sign across the back flap of the envelope. Thus, a sealed envelope containing four identical recommendation letters should be submitted per recommender, making total four, because you get it from the two recommenders. For university track applicants, you should collect one original recommendation letter from each recommender. So I think this was most challenging. Then what should I put in the section of the GPA on the application form? On the GPA for the application form, you should put, because they are divided into semesters, semester first semester and second semester in each academic year. So you put the marks, with the score which you are securing in that semester, and you put out of. If the GPA is 4.5 out of 5 or 3.6 out of 4, you put what. If it's in percentile, you keep maybe I got 80 out of 100, like that. Then must I submit the certificate of language proficiency, English or Korean, when I apply for GKS? The answer is no, like is an optional document, so which means you may apply for or without it. However, if you are an applicant from the country which is highly competitive, it is better to add it, because it can give you extra credits to secure more chances of getting this scholarship. But for your reference, if you hold a topic level, which is Korean of level 3 or above, you'll be given additional point. If you submit your certificate of English proficiency, you may be given a preference based on your test scores. Where can I submit my application? Is online submission available? The answer is no, they don't do that. So you can either submit through the university track or through the embassy of Korea in your country. More detail, you can check on their sites. When is the deadline for the application? This varies depending on every single country or university which you are applying to. Embassy, they have their own different application deadline, because the schedule of education varies from countries to country. Some countries finishes education earlier, some late. May I apply for the program by submitting my application to the NIAID directly? No, you should submit either to the embassy of Korean embassy in your country, or you submit it to the university direct. I meet all the application requirements listed in this scholarship. Am I qualified to apply for the scholarship? No, I said you should check. Mostly you may be, but to secure admission, so you should check to the university and the major which you are applying to, and check if you meet the admission criteria over there, so that you increase the chance for you to win this scholarship. Not real, but you may. My parents and I hold a different citizenship, so am I eligible to apply for the program? You should just make sure none of your parents or you holding Korean citizenship. I'm expected to complete my bachelor's or master's degree in August 2021. Am I eligible to apply for master's program under this scholarship? If you submit, you can. If you submit only an official certificate of expected graduation or a provision degree certificate issued by the university, you may apply for this scholarship. However, it is only permitted under the condition that you will submit your final degree certificate and final academic transcript to that by August 31st. The failure of doing so, it will result in cancellation of the scholarship, even if you were awarded. I'm in the last semester at one of the Korean universities. Can I apply? No, you are not. I'm currently enrolled at university in Korea pursuing master's degree. Am I eligible to apply? Yes, you are eligible to apply. So that was all about Q&A. Thanks so much for watching. I hope it was helpful for you. Do me a favor by subscribing. If you want to donate to the channel, the link of the Patreon is down there. Best wishes. See you in Korea.